Good morning, everybody. It's Wednesday, and it's time for the next part of our story about Holy Week. We're going to find out what happens to Jesus next. I am Nicki. You might know me if you have been into Rockets on a Wednesday. So today we're going to be finding out about the last meal that Jesus had with his disciples, with his friends. We call it the Last Supper. So Jesus and his friends were at a place called Jerusalem, and they were getting ready for a special meal together. So they all arrived in the room and they settled down, they got ready, and then Jesus washed the disciples' feet. Now you might think, well, that's a bit strange because I guess you don't normally wash your friends' feet when they come round for tea. But actually, in Jerusalem, it wouldn't have been that unusual at all because it was a hot and dusty place and the disciples wouldn't have been wearing, they wouldn't have had trainers to wear and they wouldn't have had wellies to put on. They would have been wearing shoes that were a little bit like sandals. So their feet would have got really dusty and really dirty. So to actually have your feet washed before a meal would have been really nice. So when they arrived, Jesus sat them down and he took a bowl of water and he went round each of them and he washed their feet in the water. Now, what would have been a little bit unusual about this is that it would normally have been the job of a servant to wash people's feet. But Jesus was the leader, but he was the one that was doing the feet washing. So they all sat down together and Jesus handed out the food. They had some bread and some wine. Let me show you. Yeah. And we have bread and wine, don't we, when we celebrate Jesus in our communion services. And the disciples were sitting and they were chatting. And it was during this time, during the meal, when Judas sneaked out of the room to go and betray Jesus. So what can we learn from the story of the Last Supper? Well, Jesus was the leader. He was the most important person in that group. But Jesus says it's really important that we don't think of ourselves as more important than others and that we are happy to serve other people and always be kind. I wonder who you could serve today. I wonder what little helpful things you could do today. I expect you're at home with the people that you live with. What could you do to help them today? Maybe you could load the dishwasher or put your toys away. I don't know. I'm sure there are lots of things that you can think of that would help the people that you live with. So I'm going to say goodbye now, and we'll be back tomorrow with the next exciting part of the story of Holy Week.